didn't think I would be defeated by a uniform species like humans. My notion should be ashamed.
And you are?
Let me introduce myself. My name is Nestor. I was once the ruler of a species whose population reached over a million.
Over a million?
We were highly adaptable to the environment and built prosperity through diversity. Even a civilization like ours ended up accepting the Lacrimosa. There is no way humans, with their meager bodies and souls, stand a chance against it.
Yes. Wide open! minute. Where is this place?
A world above the clouds. I didn't expect this. Sarai. tree of notions has grown enough. I can feel a large number of notions from the Valley of the Kings.
Yeah! We did it, Adol!
I didn't think you were going to release all those notions. Please, stop. I don't deserve to be called by that name anymore.
What do you mean?
As I mentioned before, my real name is Ura. I represent a species that possesses the power of mimicry that came from far above the sky.
What's mimicry?
It's the ability to copy another organism or object's functions.
We descended to Earth with the power of mimicry and prospered. But eventually, we accepted the Lacrimosa, and I became a protector. And after the Eternian's era began, I went down to Earth again to find the new protector of evolution amongst the Eternians.
But how did you become the Princess of Eternia?
To find the person whose heart shines the most, I thought it best to be near the royals. So I sneaked into the palace and found out that the young princess was in critical condition.
Then you...
Yes, I mimicked and replaced Princess Sarai, who had passed away. I was able to absorb her personality and appearance. And a few years later, I met you, Dana, at the Great Tree Temple.
Then... the Sarai that I've always been friends with was... Dana...
Please, don't feel bad. This was all for the Great Lacrimosa. And it was a decision that I made to protect this land.
This story again?
Even if that's true, for Dana... her good friend was an imposter. Poor sister Dana.
Imposter? That isn't true, but... no. What I have done should never be forgiven.
If you know that, then...
Huh? What is this? What's happening?
What's wrong? You look concerned.
I don't think I can make up for my actions by doing this, but...
It looks like control over my mimicry is becoming unstable. The way you talk.
It's been a while, Dana.
Sarai?
Huh? What's going on?
Don't ask me.
I am Sarai's personality, which was replicated through Ura's mimicry. To be clear, I am not the real Sarai, but I am the Sarai that spent time with you ever since we were young.
How could this happen?
Ura is normally a kind person with a virtuous will. She must be suffering from all the conflict with her duty as a protector. The fact that you all released her notions must also be affecting her.
Can that really be?
Dana.
Sarai.
I'm sorry to put you in such a harsh situation. I'm sorry that I couldn't be with you till the very end. And about Olga.
No.
Dana.
I really want to stay and talk to you. But we have to go.
Yes, You barely have any time left.
Adol, let's go to Saren Garden.
If you receive the power, please return to Lophos, Adol. If you are planning to stop the Lacrimosa, I'll explain what you'll need to do.
Really? That's helpful.
Yes. But for now, please hurry to Saren Garden.
Supposed to receive this power. Does Dana receive it?
No. The power of the notions is repelled by providence and nature. I believe it conflicts with the energy that we Eternians use. Could you please receive the power, Adol?
If you and Dana can't, then who else will do it?
Rock, paper, scissors?
I would like Adol to receive it. Now, can you lift up your sword, the symbol of your strength, to the tree?
Sword. It sure isn't normal.
That means we are fully prepared.
Yes, let's go to Lophos. Soraya's waiting for us.